Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey, and you're watching another Photoshop tutorial. This week, I'm going to show you how to create this sunset picture. Now, this picture didn't start out looking like this at all. Well, it had a tree in it, but it wasn't sunset, and it wasn't taken in front of this water. In fact, if I revert back to the original picture, what we're actually going to start with is that, which is a really boring tree, and it's a really boring picture. So how do we get from here to the sunset? Well, it's actually not too difficult. The first thing we need to do is to add the sunset colour. Now, you could do that using gradients, but personally, I prefer to do it using real images. So let's get a sunset image onto the screen. Now, this picture I took in, well, a completely different continent. But it's a straightforward picture of a sunset, nothing done to it. And if you want to download this and try it on your own pictures, you can do from the website you can see on screen now. Okay, so how are we going to add that in? Well, first of all, we need to be able to see the sunset and the tree picture together. So if you can't do that, go to Window, Arrange and Cascade so you can see multiple images on screen at once. Now let's get the Move tool and we're going to click on the sunset and drag and drop it onto the tree image. Now I'm going to hold shift as I drag and drop because holding shift means that it drops exactly in the center of the picture. And because my camera was the same for these two pictures, it fits exactly. You may find you need to stretch it or shrink it to fit your own pictures. So where's the trees gone? Well, they're still there, of course, but when we drag and drop, we automatically create a layer and it completely covers the trees underneath. What we need to do is to make these two layers work together so we can see part of the sunset and part of the tree. Now that means we're going to use blend modes. Currently the blend mode is set to normal, which means the sunset image is opaque. We can't see through it at all. But if I move the little down arrow, I can choose any one of a number of different blend modes. Now the ones you want to try are the top five, the darken, multiply, color burn, linear burn, and darker colors. Now they'll all make your image darker. And as I flick through them, you should be able to see a bit of a difference. And you need to choose one that you like the look of. Now, I quite liked the color burn one here because I like what it's done to the trees. But it's not a strong enough effect. So to bring the effect up even stronger, I'm going to duplicate this layer, the sunset layer, by dragging it down onto the new layer icon and letting go. Now, not only does it duplicate the layer, it duplicates the blend mode. So we now have an effect that's twice as strong. And now it really does look like a fiery sunset. It's actually a little bit too strong for me now. So I'm going to drop the opacity down, probably to around about sort of 50 to 60%, somewhere in that area. And that's giving me a really good sunset effect. I like the effect, particularly on the background trees, where we have a sort of semi-transparent colour coming through. It's very nice, but I don't really like it on the foreground, on this grass area, where we have a sort of light yellow patch, and it's all a bit too bright. So what I'm going to do is to click the background layer to make that active, and I'm going to darken the grass down. I'm going to use the Burn tool, which you'll find hidden away underneath the Dodge tool. There it is, Burn tool. We just need to set some of the options up. Let's set it the range to midtones, and let's bump the exposure up to about 35 to 40%. Now doing that means that it'll only work on the sort of midtone areas like the grass, and the exposure means it works reasonably quickly, but not so quick that everything goes black at the click of a mouse. Because I want to build the effect up to try and achieve something that looks kind of more realistic. So we have light patches and dark splodges, and is not just a solid black silhouette. Now you can make it a black silhouette, of course, that's fine, but I kind of like it with a bit of half and half. Now I could stop there, that looks pretty good, but I want to apply just two more effects. First of all, I want to brighten the whole picture up. Let's flatten the layers down a little bit. Let's go to Layer and Flatten Image, which just dropped off the bottom of your screen. That collapses all our layers down into one single layer, and now I can apply adjustments and levels so I can brighten it up because it looks a bit dark. And sure enough, on the levels histogram you can see there's not a lot at the light end, so let's just slide that until the whole picture brightens up a little bit. There we go, that looks better. The final effect I'm going to do is the watery effect along the bottom. Now this, to make this really easy, is going to be using a plugin filter that you can download. You can download it from the Flaming Pear website. You can see the website address on the screen now. It's free to download and free to use for the first 30 days. After that, if you like it, you need to pay for it. But during the first 30 days, it's a fully functional filter. And you'll find it once you've installed it under Filter, Flaming Pair, and Flood. Now, it pretty much does what it says. There's a few things you can change. You can change the horizon, for example, so you can decide how high up your water line needs to go. I'm thinking that's probably a bit too much global warming going on there, so let's just bring it down a little bit to around about there somewhere. You can change all of the effects that you have here to change the look and the feel of your waves. You can even randomize it if you little bit, like there's a sort of dice effect here, and if you click that, it'll randomize your waves. I quite like that, that looks quite nice, so we'll say OK to that, and that'll apply your filter to the picture. Now, it's not the fastest filter to use, it is actually quite slow, but it gets there in the end. And there you go, you now have a lovely kind of watery effect, and we now have the finished picture. So in just a few clicks of the mouse, we've gone from our starting picture, which was that, and we've made a beautiful sunset.